topic, interesting x-rays in neurosurgery by our joint secretary now, Dr. K. Subramani, please.
These are common things that I see in everyday life, but I am putting it forth to the general practitioners and other specialties here because you often come across these. It's likely to miss certain important aspects. So although this I see every day, I wanted to put it forth to you. And initially I have certain things which is just for information. Then I have some interesting things coming up behind and I will explain. Altogether it will take only 10 minutes. This is a bleeding in the brain, and one of you, I don't want the radiologist to answer, can one of you tell me what is it?
Subdural.
No sir, you are wrong. No sir, it is a bleed. It is a bleed, it's a life-threatening condition. Within several minutes to very few hours, the patient will die if the intervention is not done.
Can
you
point it out?
Yes, sir. This is not. This is a biconvex bleed. We want it to sit on. It may be easier.
Easier.
Right. I know it. I'll show you with the mouse. This is an extradural bleed, sir. This is a biconvex appearance. The bleed comes from the arteries which are outside the dura, supplying the dura. In this case, middle meningeal artery, which has been injured because the person has been involved in a road traffic accident. If you can see a little closely, there is some swelling in this side of the skin. There was a laceration here. There was a fissured fracture here. Air from outside has gone in. The small dot is a pneumocephalus. This is a biconvex appearance, like a lens. This is an extradural hematoma. If it is not operated on immediately, it will cause transtentorial coning and the patient will die. Just wanted to bring it forth because it's common to have road traffic accidents. Patients are going to the scan centers themselves. The patient will usually be walking, talking very well and come to the general practitioner, ask for advice. The advice is to get to the nearest hospital and get operated. What is this? There is a bleeding here. The white area is a bleeding. The intense white area outside is the skull. The skull has been fractured here. There is an external hematoma there. In contrast to the previous bleeding, this is concavo-convex. That means looks like a fading moon face. What bleeding is this? This is a subdural hematoma. The difference with extradural hematoma and subdural hematomas, you have a few more hours by the time the patient deteriorates. Within few hours to several hours, the patient will die if not operated. I put this picture before because I have another picture coming up where it is not very evident. There is a thin hematoma, but there is associated cellular injury here. See, normally in the brain, if you see, you can be able to make out the sulcal and diral patterns. And here it is not possible because there are associated contusion, the right frontal, left frontal, plus subdural hematoma, which is coming on to the convexity with cerebral edema. This is also potentially life threatening. There is another picture here. The set of pictures above is preoperatively. If you look closely, this is the body of the lateral ventricle. On the affected side, it is not seen. Here also it is not seen. If you leave it like this, thinking the patient will become all right in a few hours, he will develop a midline shift and his life will be lost. Needs an emergency decompression, and look how the brain has bulged outside after the decompression. Then only the body of the lateral ventricle is getting to be seen. And this is the normal gyral sulcal pattern, like the finger-like pattern here. So this much amount of decompression, almost 1.5 times the width of what is here, has to be given so that the brain will relax, and after several weeks the patient will improve. This bulge which is seen outside will slowly become plain and concave, and after that you can put back the bone plaque. What is this bleeding? This is completely inside the brain. This is intracerebral hematoma. Usually happens in undiagnosed or not well treated hypertensive patients. Of late I am seeing a lot of these bleedings in people who have been put on aspirin and clopidogrel. One word of concern here: if the patient is on aspirin, it is equally effective as putting the patient on clopidogrel. Only thing is, aspirin can be reversed with several transfusions of platelets and plasma, whereas clopidogrel cannot be reversed. So if this patient comes today and I have to operate, I can do the surgery under cover of FFP, fresh frozen plasma. But if it is clopidogrel, he will probably re-bleed again.
I can take it.
Yes, sir.
Most respected members, this again the defects of evidence-based medicine. Some of the trials that give you advices that aspirin and clopidogrel superior, they only look at one aspect of the condition of the patient. For example, coronary artery disease, they come to the conclusion that you give both the drugs, the reinfarction rate is low. Very unfortunately, such trials do not look globally to the one aspect. It's not possible, because every trial is costly, money, and to look into the all aspects globally is really, here only comes our experience-based medicine. Of late, I have also had very many gastrointestinal bleeding because of the combination of two drugs, and preference is only for only one drug, despite the advice of some of the senior cardiologists looking two drugs together to provide, for example, deep lactate, the chlorine preparation. Was nothing against the preparation, but this is one of the very well point brought out by our incoming Treasurer-Secretary, like Dr. K. Subramanian Neurosurgeon. I endorse it. One has to be very, very careful when you put both the drugs.
Personally, I prefer only aspirin. If the patient has got cardiac problems, please put him on low molecular weight heparin. It is reversible in 6 hours to 8 hours. If you feel the patient is stable, is not going for complications, then you put whatever drug you want. But if this man is going to be in hospital and you're looking at several complications, I would prefer not to give clopidogrel. As also we say, aspirin on every day, you stop aspirin, 10% of the marrow becomes normal. So in case of subdural hematomas, we have even waited 7 to 8 days, so that 70% of the platelets become normal, then we operate. In clopidogrel, it takes 3 weeks. 3 weeks patient dies. This is another patient. This is a long story. I'll make it a little short. It's a child born in 1973, seen in 74 at Madras Institute of Neurology. Itraca Plus found out, wanted to do shunt, they had refused. Seen again in 75. Head circumference has been noted. Child has been asked to report to theater for VT shunt. Refused surgery. Seen again in 75, 11th month. Okay, the head circumference seems to be coming down by 1/4 inch. Continue oral glycerol. See, those days when the patients really refused surgery, they couldn't offer much. Apo, there was no CT scan. All these findings were based on angiograms and air encephalograms. The air is instituted into the spinal cavity, and then the patient is stood up or lie down to image the ventricles. Then again 76, the child was seen walking with support. So oral glycerol was continued for more than 6 years now. When the child was 6 years of age in 1979, I termed it as arrested hydrocephalus. It's not increasing much, but again advised surgery. Again, the patient refused surgery, and we didn't hear about the patient from 6 years to 32 years. So as you have seen from the previous OP prescriptions, the patient was coming to my father. And at 32 years of age in 2003, she suddenly reported to my clinic. சரி உங்கள் அப்பா பார்த்துட்டுருந்தாரு இப்போ நீங்கள் பாருங்க இட் வாஸ் ஆல் ரைட் என்ன பண்ணுறீங்கன்னு கேட்டேன் சார்ட்டட் அக்கௌண்ட்டாக இருக்கேன் அப்படின்னாங்க வெரி ஹாப்பி திஸ் இஸ் தி வென்ட்ரிக்கிள் அட் 32 இயர்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஏஜ் ஐ குட் நாட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஹவு திஸ் லேடி கேன் பி ஏ சார்ட்டட் அக்கௌண்ட் ஐ வாஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் டோல்ட் எனக்கே மூளை கம்மியாக இருக்குது உருப்பிட மாட்டேன் ஸோ ஐ குட் நாட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் வித் வெரி தின் ஃப்ரான்டல் கார்டெக்ஸ் ஹவு திஸ் லேடி கேன் பி ஏ சார்ட்டட் அக்கௌண்ட் ஐ விஷ் ஹர் வெல் I thought we'll leave it like this. Again, she came last year. This is the ventricle. Now I hear she is a team leader in her private firm of chartered accountants. She is doing extremely well. She is the preferred chartered accountant for several of their VIP clients. And this lady kepa, you solranga, doctor, every day is my last day. I know if I have a trivial injury, I will die. I know no doctor wants to touch me. If you see the cerebral cortex, only posteriorly you see the finger-like projections. Anteriorly, there is no finger-like projection. Entire thing is thinned out. There is not even 5 millimeter of cortex. So the food for thought is, how much brain do we really need? Thank you.
What is your comments,
sir?
What is your opinion?
Sir, my humble opinion is, we still don't know anything about the brain, sir.
We still don't know anything about the brain.
See, now we have some special studies in the MRI called as diffusion tensor imaging. It images the motor tracts, and when the patients develop tumors in the brain, we are able to say by DTSI, that the tumor is developing anteriorly, the motor center is pushed posteriorly, and we are seeing these things with the later imaging. I can understand motor center, speech center being pushed here and there, but I can't understand a very thin cortical mantle by which a person to do chartered accountancy, you need to have calculation, you need to have memory, you need to have application skills, you need to have so many other things where frontal, right frontal, left frontal, cognitive, behavior, memory, association cortex, visual, so many things, which means every lobe is working. But I can't understand from the imaging how it is there and where it is working.
The same patient,
still is on follow. They think of my father as God, I think of her as God.
Very clearly shows that you don't require brain to become a successful.
No, don't require. I have too much brain.
Sir, about tumor patients, do they have any headache, any vomiting, nothing, sir?
No vomiting, only headache for 5-6 months. Yeah, was his own business, he was a salesman, he had, most of them travel about 100 kilometers a day on the bike. He was going around, coming back, eating outside, it was all great.
The
more the surface, you can store more. That is what was taught to me, which is what I don't understand looking at this.
You see, Japanese, they have a very large system, they are doing good.
Thank you very much, sir. It was a very nice essay to learn.